December 2010, Russian astronomer Leonid Elenin announces the discovery of a new comet roughly 400 million miles from Earth. Calculations show that the comet, moving on a highly eccentric orbit, will intersect the orbit of the Earth. Based on the size of its coma, most astronomers viewed the comet as typical and unexceptional, suggesting a body 2 or 3 miles wide. But the projected Earth-crossing orbit sparked an outburst of internet rumors and doomsday predictions. Most remarkable were the suggestions that the comet was a rogue planet, and claims that it would profoundly disturb the Earth, causing earthquakes or a shifting of the poles, and even the end of the world. Respected astronomers were dismayed. How could such scientific illiteracy attract millions of viewers to internet articles and videos? Experts reminded us of the trivial mass of a comet just 2 to 3 miles wide, passing millions of miles from Earth. As it turned out, what actually happened to Elenin posed a profound mystery for comet science. In the summer of 2011, Elenin grew brighter than expected, and astronomers began to anticipate a respectable show. But the situation changed when a powerful coronal mass ejection erupted from the sun. On August 19th, the CME struck the comet Elenin. The comet flared brightly, appearing to disintegrate explosively while rapidly dimming before it was visually lost against the glare of the sun. On October 24th, only days after the expected closest approach to Earth, Italian astronomers captured the remains of Elenin on film. An extremely faint and diffuse cloud of dust was all that could be seen. How did the disintegration and virtual disappearance of Elenin occur? The answer appears to lie in the role of charged particles in an electrical event. Popular astronomy imagines comets to be dirty chunks of ice moving through electrically neutral space. But a growing number of electrical experts say that comet nuclei are negatively charged. They say that a comet begins discharging electrically as it moves more deeply into the electric field of the positively charged sun. When the charged particles of a coronal mass ejection struck the comet Elenin, the oppositely charged nucleus could not withstand the electrical stresses. It disintegrated like an exploding capacitor. The electrical theorists assure us that comets are not what we were taught in school. No practical experiment ever demonstrated that a dirty chunk of ice would disintegrate explosively under gentle warming from the sun. One of the strongest challenges to astronomers' assumptions occurred in December 2011. That was when the comet Lovejoy plunged into the atmosphere of the sun. Its fate seemed certain. But to the amazement of astronomers, the comet emerged in spectacular fashion, its tail undulating violently under electromagnetic forces, then separating from the nucleus, only to be reborn after the emergence of the nucleus from the sun. The explosive demise of comets cannot be due to solar heating. In fact, eruptions and comet disintegration have occurred in regions so remote from the sun that warming is not even a factor. We saw one of the most improbable flarings in the case of Comet Halley, a regular visitor to the inner solar system. In 1991, 5 years after Halley's closest approach to the sun, it was well beyond the orbit of Uranus, where temperatures hover around minus 330 degrees Fahrenheit. It erupted, producing a dust cloud 180,000 miles across. If thermal stresses are excluded, it seems that only one consideration remains. Shortly after the Halley outburst, a few astronomers began to wonder, could charged particles from the sun be a factor? At the time, solar wind activity had peaked at a higher level than had been seen in decades. Then two astronomers observed that the charged particles of a powerful solar flare on January 31 would have likely reached Halley around February 12, the date of the outburst. The coincidence of the outburst with that arrival seemed too great to dismiss. Could electrical events be the key to comet outbursts and fragmentation? To this day, astronomers have no explanation for the sudden and spectacular brightening of Comet Holmes in 2007. It had been moving rapidly away from the sun for about 5 months when its coma size suddenly grew by a factor of a million, making it even larger than the sun. Was it a coincidence that just 2 days before the comet's display, there was a sharp spike in the output of the solar wind? In the electrical view, the sudden arrival of charged particles from the sun will explain what otherwise would have no known cause. Electrical surges and capacitor breakdowns go together. High-tech image processing later showed that the nucleus of Holmes had broken apart, with many fragments contributing to its brightening, confirming a general pattern. Comets flare brightly when breaking apart. In 1976, Comet West brightened greatly in a series of outbursts, perhaps a dozen or so, then shocked astronomers by breaking into fragments. Warming by the sun is not a reasonable explanation of such events. When Comet Virtanen fragmented in 1957, it was just inside the orbit of icy Saturn. Much the same occurred in the case of Comet Biela-Bamberg. More than once, comets have broken up at their greatest distances from the sun, well beyond the orbit of Neptune. And when breakup occurs, the fragments have separated at inexplicably high velocities. Mainstream theory has no explanation for the energies driving such events. The progressive disintegration of the comet Schwassmann-Vachmann III beginning in 1995 left astronomers grasping for answers. Though 150 million miles away, it brightened spectacularly, shining hundreds of times more brightly than expected. Then astronomers discovered that the comet had broken into at least four pieces. Then in 2006, the Hubble Space Telescope captured the spectacular disintegration of the comet in progress while it was still out beyond Earth's orbit. It was then clear that the comet had broken into more than three dozen fragments, as house-sized chunks of the comet appeared to disintegrate completely, some within the span of a single day. Remarkably similar to the fate of Elenin was the explosive demise of the comet Linear in July 2000. Like Elenin, Linear entered the inner solar system from its outermost regions on a highly eccentric orbit. For the electrical theorists, that means a maximum change in the electrical environment. As it approached its perihelion, some 70 million miles from the Sun, it flared, then rapidly disintegrated. Then came the announcement that the event produced an explosion of X-rays at the interface of the debris cloud and charged particles from the Sun. Intense interfacial energies of this sort, up to the level of X-ray emissions, can only be the signature of electric charge exchange. The disintegration of Linear provides a strong parallel to the story of Elenin. The teardrop form of the flare and the relationship of the flare to disintegration are virtually identical. All that was left of Linear was a cloud of dust. The expected abundance of water was simply not there. And what of Elenin? As reported by Leonid Elenin himself, the expected water vapor was missing. And so the mysteries of comets deepen. And the most urgent need is to reconsider the nature of comets as a whole. It's now clear that comet outbursts do not occur because of surface warming, but charged particles exploding from the Sun are implicated in cometary outbursts. Insulating material around a charged body gives way under an electrical kick or spike. The point is well illustrated in electric discharge at Stone Ridge Engineering. Here, blocks of acrylic are bombarded by high-energy electrons, creating an internal cloud of charge. But nothing spectacular happens until the blocks are tapped sharply with a metallic spike. Then charge is released through instantaneous breakdown and fracturing, the lightning pathways of the fractures frozen into acrylic. The energies of electrical breakdown and fracturing of this sort will not just explain the flaring and disintegration of comets, but the remarkable velocities at which the fragments separate. It seems that anomalies are just too easily ignored or forgotten. But recurring anomalies can be the door to discovery. What better way to move science forward than to start with the forgotten question? What is a comet? How are comets formed? What holds the cometary coma in place against the force of the solar wind? How are the long filamentary tails created and maintained in the extreme vacuum of space? What force creates and confines the powerful collimated jets from the nucleus? Where is the water ice of which all comets were supposed to be constituted? If charged particles from the Sun are triggers for outbursts or disintegration of comets, the behavior of these bodies has almost nothing to do with relative masses or surface temperatures, and everything to do with the electric force. Above all else, we must now ask, what is the comet's place in the electric universe? Is it possible that one question could remove all of the anomalies? That one answer could explain the flaring, the fragmentation, and the catastrophic demise of these cosmic intruders?